Hello everyone, my name is Adrian from 2One Labs in Germany. Today I'm here to tell you how to operate our newest 3D metal printer, the 2Create. By the way, I'm 6 feet taller for comparison. The first step after unpacking our machine is to go to the back of our machine and connect the gas hose and the power supply. The first step is to connect our 6mm gas tubing for a machine. Just plug it in and you're good to go. If you want to unplug it, just push and pull. The next step is to connect it to the power supply. Just plug in the power plug. And now, finally, we're turning the main power switch. Just a reminder, our machine runs on 230 volts and 50 hertz, so you may need a power converter for your country. After you switch the main power switch, the machine takes less than 90 seconds to fully boot up. On this front panel, you have the laser switch. When you turn it, you see this red indicator light that the laser is on. This is the emergency switch. You push it and the laser stops immediately. Pull it to reverse it. Here you have the button to open the door. Just press it for 1 second and the door will open. And last but not least, our USB port where you can upload your G-code to the machine. Now we open the door by pressing the button for 1 second. If you noticed, red is not my favorite color, so I changed the color of the processing chamber to blue, my favorite color. Now you see the interior of our processing chamber. In the front, we have the building platform, where your object or your file will be printed. Next, the powder reservoir, where all the metal powder will be contained for printing. And our circular coater, which will distribute the powder from the powder platform to the building platform. Here you can see our main user interface, where you control your 3D printing process. In the main tab, you can control our axes, the reservoir, the building platform, and the coater. To move the reservoir, there are 3 options. You can do little steps with the plus and minus button. You can just tap it and move it manually, or you can double click on reservoir and put in any value you like. As you can see, the axis is moving. For the building platform, it's the same procedure. You just move it and you see it is working. The coater is a little bit different. You have 3 options to move it. The button in the middle, when you press it, it does a whole 360-degree turn wherever the position is. You can just put it to any position manually, or you can just push this button, which brings it first to the park position, which is between the building platform and the powder platform, and the back position, which is on the opposite side, so you can remove the powder. Here you see the coater is positioned right between the building platform and the powder platform, which is the regular position where it should always be. If you push the button I've mentioned earlier, the coater will go to the opposite direction so you can put in powder or get your object out. If you push the button again, it will come right in front where it should be. Otherwise, you can move it, as I mentioned, freely with the other buttons. Now, to prepare for our printing job, we need 3 new things. A new building platform, a new rubber lip, and fresh powder. Here we have a fresh building plate. You need to put in a positioning pin
and fasten it with a 5 Allen key, and then put it into position with the hole. For the print, it's important that the building platform is 0.5 millimeters above the base plate, and for that we have a measuring tool to compensate. First, you take the measuring gauge and put it in the back and put it to zero. Then you get it to the front, put it on the base plate and move it until you are around 0.5 millimeters above. The next step is to remove the old rubber lip from the coater. For this, you need a 2.5 Allen key to remove these two screws. Just get it off and take out the old one. As you can see, the rubber blade can be damaged during the printing, so it's important to replace it after each print. Here I have a fresh rubber lip, which I put back into the frame and back onto the coater. And fasten it back with the 2.5 Allen screws. And this one's ready to go. Before we can start working with the powder, we always have to put on our PSE, or personal safety equipment. This includes our protective suit, ESD-proof shoes, rubber gloves, and our breathing mask with filters. So, before we work with the powder, you always have to look like this.
Safe and protected.
Now we'll show you how to attach the overflow bottle. First, carefully put it inside, connect the two flanges, close it, then open both valves so that the powder can go from the machine to the overflow bottle. And now we remove the overflow bottle. For this, close both valves, open the flange, and take out the bottle carefully. Be advised, if the bottle is completely full, it's quite heavy, so use both hands and be careful when you get it out and you open the flange, so the bottle will not fall down. Before we fill in the powder, we need to know how much powder do we need. For this, we have the reservoir and we can double click on it and do an auto calculation to know how much powder we need. But before, we need to load our job, so we need to know the height of the building project. For that, we need to go to the Load tab, to the browser, and select our printing job. And wait until it's fully loaded. Now that our project is fully loaded, you can see the height in Z direction, which is in this case around 90 millimeters. Go back to the main tab, press double click on the reservoir, and you do the auto calculation. You see, now it confirms our height for the powder and will move directly to it. To fill in the powder, we need to park our coater on the other side by pushing the button. Now we have plenty of room to fill in the powder. Now I will fill in the powder. Now I will use my little plastic card to distribute powder from the powder reservoir to the building platform and fill up all the little gaps around the plate. Now our goal is to distribute the powder from the powder reservoir to the building platform in between and get the building platform as clean as possible. For this, we get the coater
back to the front, onto the building platform, and then we adjust the rubber height. You see these three screws, which can be loosened with a free Allen key. Just a little turn. Then you can adjust the height with those micrometer screws to lower or heighten the rubber blade to clean the building platform. So, after several rounds around the building platform, it should look like this. Powder evenly distributed around the plate and minimal to almost non-powder on the plate. This is important because if there's too much powder on the building platform, the first layer of the object will not bond. So it's important that the building platform is as clean as possible. Before we close the door and continue with our preparations, we need to fasten the three screws again. Now they're fast. Now the internal preparations are finished and we can close up the machine. Remember, when you close the door, put a little pressure on it while you close it. So now that the machine is closed up and we don't have any direct contact with the powder anymore, you are free to remove your personal safety equipment. Before we can start our printing process, we need to fill our building chamber and our filtration system with inert gas, in this case nitrogen. Here we have two oxygen sensors, one for the chamber and one for the filter. The chamber must be below 1% and the oxygen in the filter must be below 2%, otherwise we cannot start the print. For this, we activate the inert gas. We choose fast filling, so it fills faster, and filtration system can only be activated when it reaches 2%. After about 5 minutes, the oxygen in the chamber and in the filter is below 1%, so we are good to go. Our job is loaded, and we can start our printing job. Here you have an estimated time how long the job will print, and below that is the remaining time. Laser power and spot size are regulated from our G-code. Everything else is already pre-programmed. The last step before we can start our print is to activate the laser. And then we press start. The job is now finished and it's time to put back our safety equipment. Before we can remove the job, we have to do two things first. First, we put the coater on the opposite side of the building platform and lower the powder platform so we don't actually get out fresh powder. Before we can get our job out, we move the coater so we can access it and lower our powder reservoir, so we don't use up fresh powder. Our object is currently in a lot of powder, so to remove it, we take the brush and the plastic card to gently remove the powder from the object and put it into the overflow. Right now we remove the first layer of the powder, but we have to like slowly get our object out, step by step, to remove the powder fully. Now we removed enough powder to get our object out. Just gently pull it and turn it and let the remaining powder get out of it. Everything which is left, now our finished object is out. Any remaining powder can be vacuum cleaned away. This includes everything inside the building chamber, which is not recycled.
Now that the oil part is printed, we can start with the post-processing, which includes the heat treatment in the oven and cutting down the parts with the supports with the bandsaw and remove the supports.